video. We're going to keep it short, simple, and cute. We have a mini Temu haul here. I purchased a couple of things because if you don't already know or you're new to my channel, I dibble and dab when it comes to nails. I'm not a professional. I'm self-taught and it looks a little rugged, but practice makes perfect. So anyway, I got a few nail related things, so let's get into it. Oh, I like to open these up on camera because I like the sound. I like the sound of the stuff unwrapping. So don't judge me, okay? First thing we have here are some nail stampers. Excuse my dog, girl. We just had family come visit and they just left, so the dogs were in the backyard because my grandmother is afraid of dogs. So they're finally in the house and they're telling everybody how they feel. Alright, so this is a 8-piece set, technically. There's 4 different stamping kits. Well, not stamping kits, but there's 4 different stampers, and they all come with their own scraper. So, first we have this small square one. Then we have this one. This one is dual-ended, so this one has like a mini stamper on the end, and this one's like bigger. We have a bigger one altogether, a nice big round one. And don't mind my crusty nails, y'all. I washed my hair today and my nails fell off. And I'm tired of putting them back on, so I'm ready to do a new set anyway, even though I just painted my nails like 3 days ago. And then there's this really big one. I didn't expect this one to be this big. Next, we have some cuticle oils. This is a 15 one. There was one that had 20, but it wouldn't tell me like how much was in there or if they were duplicates, because I knew of the 15. Okay, so where I got this one from, there was 15 different ones in the photo. And on the other one, there was 10 different ones on the photo, but it said a count of 20. So I'm assuming it was like double, and I was gonna go for this one. But then I seen some extra scents in this one. And yeah. First here we have lavender. And lily. I thought this was vanilla. That's why I picked it up. This one is cherry. Rose oil. Pineapple. They had a mango one. Mango is my absolute favorite to everything of everything. Strawberry. Apple. This is why I picked it up, because in the other one, it had some of these scents, but it didn't but it also didn't have some of these scents, and the other one didn't have apple in it. And who doesn't like the smell of apples? Blueberries. Sorry, I'm trying to stay in frame. I'm using this new tripod, and I should have lifted it up a little bit higher. This one is peach. At the end, well, not at the end, but when I'm done showing y'all these, I'm also going to take them out because I'm going to put them away in my nail station. And this one is, if anybody knows how to pronounce that, all I know is it's a flower. Anyway, I have a new a nail station downstairs in the like dining area. Dining slash lounge area, and I think I'm definitely gonna do a video of showing y'all the little area I have set up so far and the stuff that I have accumulated over all these hauls. This one's watermelon, but I'm putting everything away right after I'm done this video. Aloe. It kind of sucks. I really wish there was vanilla, because that's really why I bought it, because I wanted vanilla. Lemon. Now, for some odd reason, I use the ones I dislike first, and I have lemon already, and to be honest, it's not that bad. I actually kind of like the smell. It's very faint. Orange. I hate the smell of citrus. Like, those are gonna be the first ones to go. And jasmine oil, which is another flower. I wish they would have had vanilla. So I'm gonna open these pens up because they are also different colors, and I'm going to state what they are again and lay them out on the table. You know what? Maybe I should do it here so they don't slip and slide all over the place. Jasmine. Sorry, I'm looking for... They don't say what these are on the actual oil pen. It just gives you a description. Dang, y'all. You know what? I'm gonna just pull them out and show y'all what they look like, because, yeah, I actually want to know what I'm using on my hands when I'm using them. We have lemon. I mean, I could probably tell what it is based off of the color, but to be for real, I'm probably not even going to remember, y'all, once I take these out, what's what. Pineapple. Wow, I can't believe they really don't have the name of the oils on here. That's crazy. Lily is one of my favorite flowers, by the way. So, I'm upset it's not lavender, but I'm not that upset. Lily. See? And this is why. Because the other one was clear, too. And how am I supposed to know which one I'm using if they're both clear and they're not labeled on that actual stick? Aloe. I'm surprised this one's clear. I thought this one would have been green. Not mad at it though. Still gonna use it. It's well, the inside of the aloe is green. The leaf is just green. This is cherry. there go my children acting out just when I slip away to do a video, right? Story of my life. Blueberry. See, this one, I thought there was a lavender one in here, but I guess there isn't. But I already have a lavender one anyway, so I'm not even mad. I thought that would have been the color of, like, lavender, honestly. I'm trying to open this one, but it won't open for me. Here we go. This one, is that... this, whatever that is, whatever flower that is. I don't know how to pronounce it. This is what it looked like. Then we got watermelon. Pink. I thought this would have been green too, because you know every time they make like a flavor of watermelon, they make the color of the candy, or they make the color of the candy green for watermelon, which I never understood. What's this? This one is rose. This one is peach, a very faint pink. And hold on, this one's apple if you can't tell. I'm trying to open it. There we go. Now this one better be green. Don't give me no funky color now. Green. Oh, I did get lavender again. Did I forget to show y'all, or did I just forget that I did show y'all? I was about to say, because how do you not have lavender? And finally, strawberry. And the last item is the highlight of this video. It is this electric, it says electric callus remover, but it's really, well, yeah, but it's for like, you know, like them kits where they be like doing your feet and stuff, and the rough part they do on your foot when it's like dry, I guess. This is what it is, but it's electric. But also, alright, there's three different grits. There's medium, coarse, and what is it? Anyway, comes with a manual. And it's just like, you gotta keep unfolding it. It's not like a little booklet or nothing. I mean, it is a booklet, but it doesn't come in like a book. It's like you have to unfold it to see the whole thing. What is it? It's light, medium, and coarse, I guess. This is what it looks like. A nice rose gold. I think this is a coarse one. I think. Let me see. So this is a charger. Let me see if it will turn on. Oh. Yeah. There's two different settings. What this is supposed to be, but whatever it is, it's not in here. I don't know what this is supposed to be. And it comes with these. We have 3-foot files, a callus remover. This is the thing you use to help you remove the callus remover, because there's a blade. If you're not careful, you will cut yourself. You don't want to go to the hospital. There is a cuticle thing here. There's a nail file. I don't know what this is. I guess this cleans out the little in-betweens. I guess that's what that is. And we have this right here. You use this to brush your feet off or to clean your files. There's another file right here. All right. Y'all, I really don't know what this is supposed to be. So I'm going to look at the manual real quick, because I don't know if something's missing or what. Oh, that's what's missing. This thing right here. That's what's missing. Let me see if that's in here, actually. It's supposed to come in the kit, but I don't see it. That's crazy. I mean, it's no big deal. Not to me, anyway, because I got most everything that I asked for anyway. Anyway, these are two different grits too, for your feet, I believe. Anyway, I think one is coarse and the other one is, I don't want to say light, but I don't know how else to explain it. It's either coarse, light, or medium. And this one is like, you could use for your foot when it's dry. These, I wouldn't suggest you use it on dry feet. I would suggest you use them like after you soak them, when your feet are like moist, or if you're like doing it under the shower, or you got yourself a foot bath, which I do plan on getting soon. I don't have that, but you know, it's just me for right now. So, or whoever, I'll just, you know, get like a bowl and soak their feet, or soak mine if I don't do it in the shower. Oh, and it's also waterproof. This thing is waterproof. I mean, I wouldn't suggest you submerge it underwater, but you can do it when you're like in the shower. But yeah, that's the piece I was missing. That's crazy. Unless it's saying something, I don't see it. But that's neither here nor there. I'm going to oh, look at that. There's another booklet. But this one's an actual, like, book. This one's for the callus remover. Alright, y'all. That is the end of this video. I would like to welcome our new family members. I would love to wish everyone love, peace, happiness, all that good stuff. If you want to reach me, my social media platforms are in the description box. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe. And that'll be the end of this video. Hugs and kisses. Bye.